Sir, even if Skywalker is successful and destroys the battleship, how will we stand up to the combined firepower of the remaining frigates?
I thought about that, and well, I have an idea.
When we were shooting this episode, Brian O'Connell, the director, and I were looking at the footage and the dailies coming in, and there seemed to be something that wasn't adding up in the story. You weren't really getting that Ahsoka felt bad about losing these guys. You weren't really getting the tension and the drama. So this was one of those cases where we did a really big overhaul in editorial. And one of the things when I was doing that I added was the scenes where you see Ahsoka looking at the holographic table. The plan she uses where she rotates the Jedi cruiser on its side and the Y-wings fly out from underneath is actually a strategy that I read about in Timothy Zahn's novel, Heir to the Empire. And Grand Admiral Thrawn uses a very similar technique of turning his Star Destroyer on its side to lure the enemy in, thinking that the Star Destroyer is vulnerable. Then he launches all his TIE fighters out from underneath it around, and you basically it's like a pincers movement. You capture your enemy by drawing them in.
We've been outflanked. Affirmative.
That a girl, Ahsoka.
I always liked that strategy. I thought that was a really, really interesting thing to do with that ship. And there's so many great ideas and so many creative people working on Star Wars that you can always look across the spectrum of what people have done and say, yeah, that was great. And I bet a lot of people have seen that. Let's put that up on screen now, finally. And then, so there you go.
Ahsoka, this is Obi-Wan. May we begin our landing?
Yes, Master. You're cleared for ground assault.
I won't even ask where the rest of Anakin's fleet is, or why he's in an escape pod.
That's probably for the best.